Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and macOS 13 Ventura has been out to public beta testers for about a week or so, and I wanted to go over the very best features. Now, if you want to try this out early before it's released to the public, that's usually in the fall, around September or October, you can do that by going to beta.apple.com. But you'll need a supported device. If we scroll up here, you can see all of the current supported devices, and it's basically 2017 and later Macs. So the iMac and iMac Pro 2017 and later, MacBook Air 2018 and later, MacBook Pro 2017 and later, Mac Pro 2019 and later, the new Mac Studio, Mac Mini 2018 and later, and MacBook 2017 and later. If you have any of these devices, you'll be able to install macOS Ventura, whether that be the beta program or the final build when it's released to the public. Otherwise, you'll have to get other updates on older Macs, typically security updates to macOS Monterey. Now, as far as the first best feature, in my opinion, that's Stage Manager. So let's close out of this and we'll go up here to the upper right. And first I want to point out, you can see that we have our Macintosh hard drive or solid state drive and a couple folders. If we go into the control center, click on Stage Manager, click off. Stage Manager is available on all of the supported devices. And maybe let's go into Safari. Safari opens up and now it sort of looks the same as it did before, but it changes when I open an app. So if I click on music, you'll see it moves to the side and music takes center stage. So it's managing all of these different stages, and then maybe I want to open something else. So we'll open up the Finder here. We'll click on desktop and you'll see everything just sort of moves aside. I can click on them and bring them back quickly. Or if I click on maybe Safari and I want music to be off to the side, I just click and drag it where I want. Of course, I can still resize it. Or if I want to move this further over to the side and get rid of it, I can do that. So we'll click on it again, drag it in, and then let's maybe make this larger. We'll bring this in over here and you'll see it sort of slips over to the side and disappears. But if I resize this and bring it in, or I bring my cursor to the left, it pops back in. So it's pretty nice. It's an easy way to quickly organize. And if I want to get to my desktop, I just click on the desktop, everything moves aside, and we have our desktop items as well. So it's a great way to organize, especially if you have a lot of different apps. So that's the first feature that's sort of a standout feature. We'll go ahead and minimize this, close this, and close out of files. Now we'll turn off Stage Manager. And the next thing has to do with FaceTime. FaceTime is something that I use a lot, but has a new feature called Continuity Camera that allows you to use your iPhone in place of the camera on a Mac. This works great, and it's a much better camera. Now with Continuity Camera, you'll need an iPhone XR later, and it will use the camera from the iPhone instead of the camera on the Mac, which isn't as good. And so as you can see, we need some way to easily adhere it there. You can just use a tripod or anything else, but I have this nice little attachment from Belkin that they sent along a little bit early, and this was shown at WWDC. It connects via MagSafe. We just flip this open here. We'll spin it around, and then we'll just set it on the Mac. Now my iPhone is locked. It's locked and everything, no issues there. We'll just set it on top and we should be good to go. Now we'll go into FaceTime. So we'll go and bring up FaceTime and it dings and immediately connects. You don't have to do anything special. If it doesn't show up, you just click on video here and select your phone. It will unlock it and just use the camera. The screen is off and you have some great features in the upper right. So we'll click on this and you can see the video effects. So we have center stage. It will now follow me around and sort of zoom in as a cameraman. It uses the ultra wide camera, and depending on your device, you'll have different features. So you can see the features here, and we have center stage, portrait light, studio light, and desk view. Now it really depends on the device which ones you'll have available. For example, portrait mode is on iPhone XR and later. Studio light is on iPhone 12 and later. So if we click on portrait mode, it blurs the background. If we want to brighten this even more for my face, click on studio light, it darkens the background, keeps my face in focus and nice and bright. And then we have desk view, and you'll need the ultra wide for this. So click on desk view and it brings up a desk view of my hands here. So you'll see my chair, my hands, the bottom of the microphone, and this can vary a little bit. So this is something that works really well depending on what you're doing, what the desk is like. So if I slide this back a little bit, you'll see there's desk view and you can see my hands. It's using the neural engine to straighten my hands and sort of correct the overall lens of the camera. So with this, you can just maybe show a different product and you can see both your face and the desktop mode. Now you need that ultra wide camera to do the desk view. So iPhone 11 and later. And then of course we have the studio light, center stage and portrait mode, depending on which device you have. Now, one other thing to note is when you don't have these features on, it can use the better camera on your iPhone. If you turn on maybe center stage, it switches to the ultra wide, which isn't as good. So if you want the best quality, turn that off, maybe use portrait mode and you're using the best camera on the iPhone instead of the ultra wide. It works really well. Again, studio light too, but if you want center stage, you'll need the ultra wide as well as desk view. So center stage is a game changer. And like I said, you don't need it on the back of your device. You can just take it off and you'll see here I'm hand holding it and it's working fine. So you can put it on a tripod or anything else, but this works really, really well. Now we have a new settings panel as well. And if we go into settings, we'll talk about this in a moment, but under accessibility, go down to live captions. We have live captions and this is great for accessibility. So we can turn it on in app. We'll turn it on. Sometimes it doesn't turn on right away, but we have live captions that will actually record what I'm saying in real time and then transcribe it. Now, again, this is in beta, so it's something you can use in FaceTime. You can also hand off your FaceTime calls finally between different devices. So maybe you're on your Mac, you need to continue on your phone, and maybe you're going outside of the room you're in or an office, you can continue and just hand it off. So these are features that are available in Ventura and some of the best things I've seen as far as really improvements on daily use type of features. So something I'll be using regularly is this continuity camera. It's so much better using the camera on the iPhone. With macOS Ventura, Apple completely redesigned system preferences, renamed it to system settings, and made it look more similar to what we have with iOS and iPadOS. So some of you will absolutely love this, others will not like it if you prefer the traditional look. However, it's very familiar now. So we have our Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and network, then of course our notifications, sound, focus, and screen time. It's the same sort of layout as we get on iOS. So if we go into general, we have about and software update and storage, and everything is very familiar. So that's something I think a lot of people will really appreciate, especially if they're newer to Mac. If they're not, of course, this will be a bit of a change as not everything seems to be here yet as well. But if we scroll down, you can see if we go into wallpaper, it looks a little bit different. And you've got dynamic desktop, and then much more. So if we scroll from left to right, we can show all, and then we have options to fill the screen, fit to screen, stretch to fill screen or center. So it's the same sort of thing, just laid out completely different. The same is true with battery. Battery looks the same. It says battery health normal. And I think this is something they should bring to iOS as well. So here it's just saying normal, your battery's fine. And if you want more information, you click on the eye and it tells you the current capacity of the battery. So that's something I think is a great way to view this. And then of course you have the same sort of battery setup that we do on iOS. If we scroll down even further, Apple has updated their keyboard and trackpad settings and added new animations as well for the gestures. So as you can see here, scroll to zoom and then more gestures. So if maybe we want to go to the gestures and then we go to one of these gestures, it shows with different animations what those are and how to do it. So the trackpad's on the left, and then you have your window on the right. Of course, if you have a mouse, this can change if you're in your settings for that. And then if we scroll down, you've got your notifications and it's explaining how to use everything. Very simple and straightforward as we mouse over mission control and app expose and more. So I think this is a nice update. They didn't have these animations in the initial betas of this, but I think this is a very simple and elegant way to show how to use those features. Three fingers down and you'll see it splits the windows out if you have multiple windows open. So if you love this, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below, or if you prefer system preferences, I'd love to hear from you there as well. But it's definitely a change. It's pretty familiar, but again, many may not prefer it. Now, just like iOS and iPadOS 16, macOS Ventura gains updates to messages. These are super helpful if you use messages regularly. And as you can see here, I'll just say this is a test message for a video. And if I send this, I can right click or option click on it. I can undo send within 15 minutes, and I can also edit the message, change what I want to, and then hit enter again, and it updates and sends it. Now, if someone is on a previous version, it will actually send another message saying that it's been edited. So if they're not yet on iOS 16 or iPadOS 16, or maybe they're still on macOS Catalina, it will send a message to them letting them know. We can also recover recently deleted messages. So if we go up here to view, we have recently deleted. We have unread messages, unknown senders, and known senders. So this is something that's really nice to see and definitely makes using messages even better and adds features some other messaging apps have had for a while also. You can also share play via messages, collaboration invitations and updates can come through messages, and also more apps can now show who shared something with you in messages. So not just the Apple native apps can do that, but other apps can do that as well. Now Mail gets some major updates also. If we go into Mail, and within Mail, it doesn't look too different right now, but if I click on create a message, and then maybe I send a message to myself, and this is a test message, and we'll just say, hello, this is a test message. And then we go to send it. Next to the send option, we have some new options, such as send now, send at 9 p.m. tonight, or send later. So those are some nice new options where we don't have to send it immediately. We can get whatever we want ready and then send it. And then also, of course, all of your regular fields here as well. Now, once we've sent this, we'll let it send. Now we can also undo send within 5 minutes. And then also if we option click or right click on an email, we can have it remind us to follow up. Remind me in an hour, remind me tonight, tomorrow, or remind me later. Also, if someone has sent you an email asking for a follow-up, it intelligently knows and will actually give you an option to follow up with that person. So a lot of smart new features built in. There's also smart search suggestions, smart search corrections. So maybe you're searching for something you misspell and it will still find those. It'll also let you know if maybe you needed to include an attachment and you forgot to send it, if someone was asking for that. And also it has rich links, also brand indicators for message identification. So features we've seen in other Mail apps, but now it's built in and it's all private and done by the Neural Engine. These are some great features. Now, if we go back into settings, there's something that will be really helpful in the future, and that has to do with software updates. We'll click on software update, click on the I, and as you can see here, it says install security responses and system files. And this is really helpful in that it will install different files other than the whole update. So maybe macOS Ventura 13.1 comes out. Well, in between that, if they find security issues, they can push another update. Just like you can with regular updates, you don't have to install them right away. It can do it automatically, or you don't have to have it do that, but it will at least give you the option and it can install them in the background. If you turn it off, you'll still see it and you'll be able to install it. But it's great that they don't have to update the whole OS now every time they need to send a security update. There's also another major feature we've wanted for a while, and that has to do with photos. So if we go into photos, so we're within photos and you can see there's a bunch of M2 MacBook Air photos. These were just used to take one for the thumbnail of the M2 MacBook Air video. But if we go up to photos in the upper left, click on settings, you'll see we now have the option for a shared library. We can share an iCloud photo library with someone else instead of having them constantly split between devices. So you can share with a spouse, a loved one, significant other, family member, or friend. You can share with anyone, just add a participant, and then you have them shared. You also get some options with that. So you have the option to view both libraries, your own library or the shared library, and you don't have to share all photos with them. You can share some of them. So there's a lot of great ways to share some of these photos. And with iOS 16, there's a button so that when you take a photo, it can share automatically or not at all. So some great options with that, and you get to see them on the Photos app on your Mac. There's other options and changes in photos as well, but that's the major one. Spotlight Search gets a major update as well. So if I hit Command Space, we can bring up Spotlight Search, or you can click the little magnifying glass in the upper right. And if we search for photos of a car, just something simple, give it a moment, it finds some. And if I click on one and then press the space bar, we can preview it now. So this is something we couldn't do before. We can preview different documents and more, and websites and everything else. So it's really nice that they've updated that. There's additional changes. It can search for more. And if we go into system settings, Go into settings, go to Siri and Spotlight. You can see all of the different things it can search for. Everything from calculator, contacts, conversations, Siri suggestions, spreadsheets, system settings, and more. So a lot of things that it can do. Now, something else other than Spotlight search is we have the clock and the weather app. They've brought those to macOS. So we have our clock app. We also have the weather app, and we can just run those in a window like we always would. So you have your world clocks, alarms, stopwatch, and timer. So basically the same thing we get on iOS, just making everything more and more similar across the platforms. Now there's a lot of different changes when it comes to accessibility and more. If you go under accessibility, other than the one I already mentioned, under accessibility, you have things such as background sounds. Under audio, scroll down, we have background sounds. Apple has added a lot of the things that we get with iOS to macOS as well. And so if you want to see all of the additional features, there's a ton of them, but I went over the major features. If you go to apple.com, click on Mac, then click on Monterey. Once this is updated, it will be easier to access. But if we scroll down just a little bit, you can see the preview of macOS Ventura. Click on that, and then you can click on All New Features. And this shows everything that's new, from Spotlight to Safari to Passkeys to Messages and much more. I covered the major features that most people will notice, but there is a lot of different changes, from Continuity Camera to a new app called Freeform for collaboration that's coming later this year, to the redesign of settings, security updates, accessibility, and more. So a lot of changes throughout. Some are big, some are small, but those are the major ones and the best ones I think most people will notice in macOS Ventura. Let me know which feature is your favorite in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.